Hello, and welcome on back to TutsByKai. I'm Kai, and today we're getting started making a 2D ring graphic. I previously made a tutorial on how to make a circle 2D motion graphic, and it was requested that I do a more of a ring style. So pretty much just have a circle in the middle of it. So that's what we're going to do today. So we're going to get started and delete the default cube with the delete and left click. The lamp, same way, and the camera. We're going to hit 1 on our numpad. I'm using the middle mouse button to move around my scene, by the way, clicking on it. And we're going to hit 1 on my numpad to go into the front-facing view. We're going to go to create and scroll down until you find the camera and click camera. We're going to drag that back. And hit 0 to go into the camera's view. Things are going to get a bit different here than the first tutorial. This is where things change a bit. So, we're going to add in a plane. We're going to drag this open a little bit. We're going to add in the plane, just like we did before, plane. And we're going to hit RX 90 on our keyboard to rotate that on the X-axis 90 degrees. We're going to zoom in and hit tab on our keyboard. This brings up the edit mode. And now what we need to do is we need to add in two cuts on the Z and the X axis. So the way we do this is we're going to go to Tools and then hit Loop, Cut, and Slide. Now this is a tool that we can use to cut an object in half. So we're going to add one there, but you're going to click. This pink line appears once you go to the edge of an object. It goes pink. So we're going to hit one there. Boom. We're just going to click. And as you can tell, I can drag this around. So what we're going to do is we're going to right click to cancel that movement. And then we're going to add another loop, cut, and slide. Just one right there, right on the edge. And then right click to cancel the movement. So now we have 4 squares, pretty much is what you're seeing, right? 4 squares. And what we can do with these is do what we need to do. So we need to add in one more loop, cut, and slide. And we're going to add that right here. As you can tell, it segments it by the cuts. So we could only cut in the middle and on the and directly in the center before. But now we have a few more options. So we're going to cut right there, once there. Boom. So now we have all the vertices we need. What we're going to do is we're going to delete all of these that we don't need. Because we don't need any of these except for the first two. We don't need anything but this one. And this one. We need the top one and the one right here in the middle there. So we're going to delete all of these other vertices because we don't need them. They're gone. All right, so now we pretty much just have this line. And I know what you're thinking. Kai, how do you make a circle from a line? The same way we've done it before. And the way we do that is we go over to the Modifiers tab. And we're going to hit Add Modifier and go to Screw. Look at that. Boom. Now we instantly have a ring 2D graphic. So pretty much this is where it gets back on the same track as being the same as my previous tutorial. If you didn't see that, I'll put a link up. I'll put a card up on the screen right about now. And you'll be able to see that if you need to see it. So pretty much what we just did was we made a screw. Screw pretty much just takes 2 vertices and rotates them. As you can tell, it just duplicates them there, there, there. If I hit apply on this, you can see that all of the vertices go like this. But it's very, very low resolution. I'm going to undo that. It's very, very low steps. It's only 16. So we're going to drag this all the way up to 512. 512 is the max. This is nice on the steps for viewing it. But if I render this like this, as you can tell, it still looks like the 16 by 16 because we didn't up the render steps. We need to up that as well. Make sure you don't forget that. That's very important. So now we pretty much have a donut. Or if you want to lower this a lot more, you can make an actual screw, like a bolt. It looks pretty cool. So let's put that back up. Now, the way we animate this is we go to the zero frame, make sure it says zero on the start, and we're going to do the same thing we did before. So we're going to put this on zero on the zeroth frame, and then we're going to hit I on our keyboard. Make sure you hover your cursor inside the angle box and hit I on your keyboard. And then we're going to go to the fifth frame, and we're going to type in 250, up 250, and then we're going to hit I. Just like that, right? Oh, I seem to have lost the plane there. Oh, I'm on the wrong layer right there. That was weird. All right, so make sure that says 250 and hit I on your keyboard to insert that keyframe. So now we have it going from being 0 to 250. So now we need it to finish up. We're going to go to the 15th frame, give it a bit of time to finish up, and we're going to 360. Hit 360 on your keyboard, hit I. Now we have the full animation here. This is what it does. Boom. Just like that. Perfect, right? If you want to change this thickness, the way you do this is really cool. If you go back into tab mode, as you can tell, if you drag this bottom vertice or the top vertice, if you drag this bottom vertice, you can make it smaller on the fly right there. It's amazing. This is super, super handy stuff. And the way we can animate this is actually, as you can tell, you can't animate in tab. You can't edit in edit mode. You can't add keyframes in edit mode, which is a shame. But how we work around that is we go over here to this data tab, object data, and we hit and we click that. Now, this whole panel brings up shape keys. Shape keys is something we can use to insert keyframes in edit mode, which is super cool stuff. So we're going to add in, not in edit mode, because we can't do it in edit mode. We can click this plus over here twice. Hit that plus twice to bring up basis and key one. Now, pretty much what this did was nothing. It did nothing. We have to animate this ourselves. So pretty much this basis is telling this plane, this circle now, that we need to keep it the way it is. And then key one is saying we need to change it. So what we need to change it to is this. We need to hit tab, and we need to drag this to this top vertice up here. But as you can tell, I can't get that perfect. There's always going to be a bit of a line there. If I render this, if I drag the value up and then render this, you can see there's a line there. And instead of trying to get this perfect, you know, scrolling all the way in and, you know, getting it perfect like that, I'm never going to get it 100% perfect. So let's undo that. A way we can do this absolutely 100% perfectly is we can add in snap mode, the magnet down here. If we click that, and then we make sure this is on vertex mode, and then we move this up, as you can tell, it snaps right to that vertice. So now it's perfect. So if we release that and hit tab again, you can tell that this line is completely gone. If I get rid of that, you can't see the line at all. The line is no longer there. You can't see it anymore. 100% perfect, lined up perfectly. But now the problem is I won't be able to grab this guy because there's nothing for me to grab. It's completely scaled to zero. So I have to hit this plane up here. If I hit plane, then you should be able to grab that bad boy once again. So now the way we animate this is we go to the zero frame. And make sure this value is on 1. And then hit I. Hover your cursor inside this box and hit I. Now we're going to go to the 5th frame, or your 2nd frame, whatever frame that's on. And then we're going to hit 0.4, like that. Right? And then hit I. Now we're going to drag this all the way back down. Go all the way down and hit I. But now, that is pretty much it. We have our circle, and it gets smaller. And it fills out as it zooms around like that. Pretty cool stuff. And one last thing I want to do is I want to rotate this as it's coming in. So we're going to hit I for rotation on the first frame, our first keyframe. And then on the 5th frame, we're going to rotate this by 25 degrees. And then we're going to hit rotation. And then we're going to go to the 15th frame, and we're going to hit R, Y, 45. And then hit I. As you can tell, it didn't do much because it's connected, but it did. So this is what it looks like. Right there. So you can't really tell because it's going the same way that it's coming. So instead of doing that, we're going to undo that. And we're going to make sure all those numbers we just put in were negative. So RY negative 25, I on our keyboard. Go to the 5th frame, RY negative 45, enter. Right? So now it doesn't look like it just stays still. Right? So it does that. I'm not sure why this last keyframe didn't go in, though. That's weird. And we're going to do a negative 45 again, and then hit I location. Oh, excuse me, I rotation. That's why it didn't go in. All right, so there we go. Now that's good. There we go. So now our animation is 100% finished. It rotates as it comes in. It gets bigger. It goes all the way around. Really cool stuff here. I really, really enjoy making these 2D motion graphics tutorials. I haven't seen a lot of people doing motion graphic tutorials, so I'm glad I can assist. Since we did this in Blender Render, you can always switch on over to Cycles since we didn't add any materials or anything like that, and then hit on Motion Blur. Make sure that's on. Because this Motion Blur is a lot better than the Blender Render Motion Blur. So we're going to make sure this says Ambient Occlusion. Make sure this is all the way black, and hit Use Nodes. So now we have our 100% stark white circle in our black background with the perfect motion blur. That's good. I'm going to use Cycles Renders for this. So that is pretty much it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more tutorials just like this, I post them weekly. I'll be posting more stuff just like this. Let me know what you want to see down below. And for the next tutorial, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye. Hey, 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 TutsByKai.